The other announcement I have is about prayer tomorrow night. I'm postponing prayer for a very good reason. Of course, it's a holiday tomorrow, and then it's the second inauguration of our president. Two historic days in one for black folks. That's something, well, one for black folks. Well, actually, they're both for all of us because both men represent this country. So let me take that back. I don't want to sound prejudiced or racist up here. There's as important as it is for our president tomorrow. The most important thing that I think about is what the man before him did in our lives and for our lives. And he gave his life, and that's Reverend Martin Luther King. I want to say that, if you could add a chapter to the Bible, to the New Testament, it would be the Book of Mormon. Because I believe that he was the last of the saints to receive revelations. Now, the world called them dreams, but I believe they were revelations. And we've seen those revelations unfold before our very eyes. So he was truly anointed by God. God gave us a wonderful person, not just for us. He gave Martin to the world. I can't think of anyone that's more loved and more respected, even today, than he was when he was alive. And so I'm so blessed that he was in my lifetime, that I got to see a living saint. So be mindful of what tomorrow means. And like I say, Monday night is postponed. But be diligent in your prayers for both of them. Pray for Martin, pray for our president. If I got a minute, I'd like to lead us in prayer. Pray for our president, all right? Our Father in heaven, we thank you, Lord, for giving us another opportunity to be served by one of the greats. We thank you, Lord, for giving him another 4 years to serve this country, black, red, white, all of us. Father, we pray that you watch over him, protect his family, watch over his cabinet, and see to it, Father, that he continues to do the work that you put in his hands to do. We pray, Father, that everything that he set his hands and his minds to do, that is guided and ordered by you. So, Father, we pray for protection for him, his family, his cabinet, that you continue to guide him for this next 4 years, and that everything for us that you give him to do, that he's able to accomplish. We pray, Father, that you soften the hearts of the ones that resist him, that even hate him. Because when they hate him, they hate us. So we pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, that you watch over him and guide him, nurture him, and keep him for us, for this country, and for the world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.